And there you have it. That's what we call music for the spirit, music for the soul, music for the body. Sha Sha, live on Power Weekend. What a performance. And that was Library Jams, brought to you, of course, by the Goethe-Institut in partnership with Power 88.7. And this amazing talent is also joining us in studio. Shamiso Mapambiro, the multi-award-winning Sha Sha. I feel like we need to bring back that Mahofi. Hey, Mahofi, 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 Mahofi. The multi-award-winning Sha Sha.
Yebo.
How you doing?
I am great.
What a performance, eh?
Thank you.
It fed my soul.
Thank you so much, man.
You know, I keep telling people that, you know what, a lot of Amapiano, especially the Amapiano that we play on the station,
yeah,
are very soulful.
Yes.
Yeah. So what inspires your soul?
Ooh, to be honest with you, it's really experiences. Mm-hmm. It's my own personal experiences to other people's experiences, mostly with love, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
That's what I really draw my energy from.
No, fantastic. You know what? You've been dominating charts. You've been selling out shows, winning awards left, right, and center. Clearly, life is going well for you, eh?
I won't lie. I would love to thank God for it.
Yeah.
Yes, it's been really good. It's been exciting. It's been exciting. It's been overwhelming. It's been amazing. It's been everything.
Uh-huh.
Everything good.
Yeah. Yeah. Would you say this is something that you would have or you have envisaged prior to getting into the industry?
To be frank with you, actually, I was supposed to be a nurse.
Yeah.
I was supposed to be a nurse. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I've been saying this. I was actually supposed to be a nurse. I never saw this coming. Yeah. I never saw music as something that I would actually start making money off and be a career and all of that, because I'm from Zimbabwe.
Mm-hmm.
And my people back at home, my parents, they expected me to go and do nursing or something, you know, academic.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden I just go like, guys, I want to do music. And uh-huh. they're like, and then they're just like, what? Are you crazy? Like, where? Here? Uh-huh. Zimbabwe? No, man, you're not. So my parents were entirely not, like, they were super against it, hey?
Yeah.
So it took a lot. I had to be super bold. I had to work really hard to, like, be like, yo, this is a thing. This is what I want to do.
Yeah.
And you got to believe me.
And you've done fantastically well, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, prior to you coming here, I was reading up on this very same story that you're talking about. Yeah. I want to get into it in a bit. But you also mentioned that you're from Zimbabwe, just in case somebody doesn't know, originally you are from Zimbabwe.
Yes.
You know, and once again, prior to you coming here, I wanted to impress you. So I went on to Google Translate, you know, just to find out some Shona terms, you know?
Yes.
Mawia?
And it was very, 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 very perfect. The way you're saying it.
Yeah.
Ah, it's perfect, dude.
What kind?
Dashika.
Yeah, that's fine. That's right. But back to the story. I mean, you did mention that you were planning a career in the health sector.
Yes.
Whilst I was reading your story, I thought, you know what? This could actually be turned into a movie of some sort. From planning the career in the health sector to your friends submitting your music to the radio, and then your cab driver Melusi Saba introducing you to Maporis.
Yes.
That could be turned into a movie. Are there plans?
You know what? Documentary.
Documentary?
Documentary.
Alright, no, fantastic. So we'll get into more of the story via our social media pages as well.
Yeah.
Let's start with your collaboration with the Goethe-Institut. How was it performing, you know, during these trying times, especially in the library?
Honestly speaking, I had a good time. I had a good time on the stage. It was a really, should I say, you know, I always enjoy my time on the stage. It's actually my therapy. Like, I feel like I'm just letting go and letting loose, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, yes, it's been such a crazy year. It's been crazy. And I won't lie, that every time when I get on the stage, for me, it's a moment where I just, like, hoo-sah. I'm just like, okay, you know what? Everything mm-hmm. is what it is right now. But, you know what? Let me have a good time. Let me have good time with everybody else.
Yeah.
Let me share my energy with everybody else. Let's all have a good vibe, you know. And that's exactly what I felt on that stage, really.
Sure. And I mean, your energy is always felt. And I mean, I'm sure the person who's listening now can attest to that as well, you know. But I mean, the reason why the Goethe-Institut also started these sessions, the library jams sessions, is also to support artists, you know, during these trying times. Yeah. Personally, how would you, I mean, as I said, you have been doing really well.
Yes.
But surely COVID-19 has affected you as well.
Of course. Dude, I actually was supposed to fly to LA to receive my BET
Your
award.
BET award! Yeah. By the way, congratulations for that. Yeah? Like I said, you've been winning awards left, right, and center.
Thank you. I would have, there's so many things I would have done, you know, this past 2020.
Yeah.
But man, like, with even with the performances, what, you know, it was all cut down, and we have social media to, you know, stay in contact and still be in contact with our fans and do what we can, you understand? And we have platforms like
the Library Jams sessions.
Yes, exactly. So, honestly speaking, we had platforms that would help us through these situations, through this trying times with the
Rona.
With the Rona. But yeah, like, man, like, that for me, performance is everything. I had a blast when I was on that stage, and I would just like to continue giving more good vibes.
No, and I mean, you've, like I said, you've been doing that, and you've also done it recently for December with your new song, which we are going to play. But I want to tap into where it all started for you. I mean, you know, I mentioned it as well in passing, your friends taking your music to the radio. But at the time, you were not convinced that you could make it in the music industry. Now, with all these achievements now, are you convinced, Sha Sha?
Oh, best believe, I'm super confident. What are you saying?
Yeah.
I'm super confident. I'm super confident with myself and where I've gotten to, where I am right now. Mm-hmm. It's all really, like, an affirmation of, like, actually, this is all the hard work that I've been really putting into, and here it is now coming out.
You know, and as you are saying affirmation, something that's coming to my mind right now is the word validation. I mean, for somebody who's an artist like yourself, and by the way, I don't use that term lightly.
Yes.
You are an artist.
Yes.
How important is validation for you?
You know, that thing, to be honest with you, it you have to be careful with it, because some people would leave off that. Be like, okay, oh, I gotta see what they're gonna say. And it's not that in that way, it's not healthy, you know. But I feel, for me, having to feel that feeling of validation is like, oh my gosh, like, my hard work has paid off, you know. And having to see people vibe with the music I like too, you know, whatever I make is something that I enjoy.
We have to talk about that. What you make and what you like as well. But we'll get into it after we play this amazing song of yours. You know, first time I listened to the song, I said, I know, hashtag it December, boss. Eh? So tell us about the single that is Waza.
So Waza is for December. It's December, it's everything December. It's all party, to be honest with you. I felt like I wanted to give that to the people, because people always just thought I'm just so lovey-dovey and like, ooh. But I just felt like
I can see that.
You know, after this crazy year we've had, let's let our hair down, let's have like a super crazy ass December.
Alright, fantastic. There you have it, Sha Sha Live on Power Weekend. Any question that you have, do let me know at @AB_broadcaster, #LibraryJams, #PowerWeekend. Here's this massive jam, one for December, Sha Sha. This one is called Waza. Alright.
I don't know if crazy ass is okay on radio.
No, it's fine. That's chill, man.
I just thought about that.
As long as I didn't say it. That's fine. my jam. Yo, dude, like, you're doing really well. Shut up.
Thank you.
If your music is playing on this station in particular, it means, because our target market is like, our epicenter is 35. Right, so we play mostly the soulful stuff. Even the yanos that we play, they need to be soulful. Yeah, so they must make sense to the mature ear. So your sound makes sense to the mature
ear. That is awesome.
I don't know how long we have, because I want the song to continue playing.
Okay, this song is probably like
4 or 5 minutes. Yeah, it's 5 minutes. So I'm left with about 4 minutes. So yeah, this is the first pre-recorded interview I've ever done. That's in studio like this. The other ones I'd be probably at an event or something.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, so this is like, okay, let's do it. It's Sha Sha, yo.
I'm having a good time,
I'm like. No, shut up.
It's all chill.
Yeah, we are live. Sha Sha in the building. This is a pre-recorded interview. You know what it is. Looking pretty in pink. Is that pink?
Yes, it is.
All right. So men are not as colorblind as we've been made to believe. So.
Oh my god.
Yeah, right. So you guys are all to the Northwest now.
Yes. No. See, I have to like it.
Oh, Val,
yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Val is approaching blonde, I think. So, but at least you're busy now, man.
Oh, no, it is busy.
Oh, okay, that's right.
It is busy.
Busy means it's the good. Bag.
Yes, shut it's up. Good. Yo, after this year, December is.
Man, it would have been so dope to be in LA.
Bruh.
What?
Bruh. Freaking man. LA and holding that thing. Like.
Exactly. But shut up, man. When did it start for you? 2013?
Yes.
I kind of lived your life a bit prior to you coming here.
Really?
That's so I can get a good idea. Yeah. No, via like obviously interviews that you've done. Yeah, that's what I mean. Your social media. I'm actually impressed by your Twitter. I'm not a social media person that much.
Yeah. Me too, to be frank with you.
You what?
Me too. I just like you're not a social media. Me too.
Yeah. Man, this is like another interview, but yeah, this is for the video people who will be watching on YouTube.
This I feel so relaxed. Relaxed version.
Exactly. This is. Power Weekend extra. No, shout out. Because I'm very, you know, I don't know what your reasons are, but the influence is real out there, you know?
Yeah.
And it's not just good influence. There's a lot of good influence. That's why I said I'm very impressed by your Twitter.
Thank you.
You know, because there's a lot of motivation and stuff in there.
I like being light. I like being more positive.
That's beautiful, vibes.
Because if you're that's what you attract back.
Yeah.
So you'd rather have that energy.
Man, you know what? Let's include this for the audio people as well.
Yes.
Hashtag December Boss, hashtag Power 987 Music, hashtag Power 987 Sum, and of course, hashtag Library Jams. Sha Sha with Woza, this is a new single and it's sounding also fantastic. But then again, everything that this woman touches, it turns into gold, or should we say platinum?
Hey, okay.
Yeah? you are receiving that.
I receive all of it.
The Queen of Amapiano, yes, the first lady of the Yanos. You know, just about every interview, they mention that you are the queen, you're the first lady of Amapiano. Are you owning that now?
Not even now. I've been, the moment that came out, I've been embracing it.
Yeah.
You know, I've been embracing it. And for me, it's like, yeah, man, like, you say that's what it is. Okay, great. Let's go. Let's take it.
Doesn't it come with some form of pressure, though?
To be frank with you, no. Because, you know, I've had this before. But, I feel like for me, at the end of the day, all of it is music. And for me, I'll probably just say, I really would say that I'm a musician at the end of the day. Because, like, I could touch hip-hop, R&B, tropical house, whatever it is. For me, it's a different way of, like, expressing myself. And whatever I do is because I like it. Because I've been so exposed to different sounds and genres and places. Mm-hmm. I moved a lot growing up. So, so that's why, for me, it's just like, at the end of the day, all these sounds and all these things, it just... it's things that I like. It's music.
I love that.
You know?
And like I said, I mean, I don't use the term artist lightly.
Yeah.
Every time I listen to Sha Sha, I feel like I'm listening to some artistry. And I mean, talking about all the different sounds you've moved from, you know, over the years.
Yeah,
yeah. You know, a little birdie told me that Sha Sha used to do country music. I'm like, what?
Oh my God, you're the first.
As you see, I told you I was living your life prior to this. I had to stalk you just so I had a good idea of who Sha Sha is, you know? So country music?
Yeah.
What inspired that?
I remember when I was still in high school, and I remember I was still in the Val, and I went to Cuddle de Vet. It was mostly like... boers mostly.
Uh-huh.
And that's what I was exposed to at that time. You know, there's a lot of rock music, a lot of top music.
Mm-hmm.
And I was exposed to that. And during that time, that was the first time I think I kind of started tapping into, like, writing. You know, writing. Yes, it started as poetry. And I was just writing. And then it kind of just, okay, now I'm starting to like the Avril Lavigne
You know, the real rockheads will tell you that is actually not rock. Or those who call
actually,
themselves
it's not
the
rock,
real,
right? Okay. It's not. I'm sorry, guys. Sorry.
Yeah.
I'm not a rockhead. Yeah. I think that's probably what?
Many call it alternative, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So, I went into that a little bit and... yeah, then the Taylor Swift, I remember that.
The more poppy stuff.
Poppy, really, really poppy stuff. So, from there, I just was just like, okay, this is so cool, let me just try and do it. And then I just started doing it just for the fun of it.
Uh-huh.
You know, and then the fact that I just kept on moving, and then I went to Mozambique, and then I went to Zimbabwe, and then I was in Mutare, and I was in Harare, and then I was like exposed to like the hip-hop, because I remember my brother... listen to hip-hop most of the time.
Sure.
That's where I got to listen. What's this? I remember during that time it was like Graduation, Kanye West.
Oh, okay.
Yo, like...
That's a fantastic album.
Yeah, yeah.
Sure.
So it was just different types of, like, everything.
Yeah.
And back at home, now I'm introduced to Afropop, you know. And yeah, it just kept on growing, you know. Thing is, I'm always just moving with the time, and I'm I love this. Oh, I love this. You know, that type of situation, and
you know what?
It's just been rubbing off me, and
there's so much to explore about Sha Sha. You know, I get a feeling not too long from now we'll have more time to actually, you know, find out more. You know, especially from a spiritual point of view, because it's something I picked out from your social media. We are also going to put this on YouTube. You're probably going to see it in the video. Like, she's a very inspirational person. You're a very inspirational person. And that really, you know, it uplifted me, like what I saw on your social media. But yeah, we'll get into that some other time. What next for Sha Sha?
Ooh, I am working on my album right now.
Uh-huh.
I'm looking forward to that. And that documentary.
Oh, and the documentary. Yeah.
And the documentary. And a whole lot more that I guess you guys will find out as it all unravels.
All right. No, fantastic. Sha Sha, it was an absolute pleasure having you in studio. Fantastic performance, by the way.
Thank you.
Totally loved it. All right, there you have it. That was Sha Sha. If you want to follow her on social media.
So on Instagram, it's Sha Sha Official One. On Facebook, it's Sha Sha. On Twitter, it's Sha Sha.
All right, no, fantastic. That was the second installment of the Library Jam Sessions. Of course, brought to you by the Goethe-Institut in partnership with Power 98.7. You can also find the link via the Goethe-Institut's website. Beautiful performance. Next Friday, we'll be hanging out with our final guest. You don't want to miss it. But otherwise, the music continues. All right. Sha, 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 sha.